very warm welcome to artist Veer Munshi, who was born in Srinagar, Kashmir, studied fine arts from MS University, Baroda. Munshi consistently used his art to reflect his anguish at the situation in his home state, his pain and struggles spilling over onto his canvas. Making a human rights statement rather than a political one, he has constantly sought to highlight the turmoil that comes with his separation from his heritage. We are very happy to have him at the Artist Festival last day, 2020. A very warm welcome to Artist Veer Munshi.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure and honor, and having some time spent with you in the morning for a breakfast.
Yeah, I'm sure. I really enjoyed that trip and the way you organize the Artist Festival.
Thank you.
I've seen the works around and many other artists. It was a good learning with other than working in studios. Exactly. So it is always good to have site-specific works, especially your area of work, because everyone has its own area. So you have chosen one of the areas, which is very fascinating. I think it will give a lot to the coming generation, the other artists, and also the city itself, the Jaipur and Rajasthan. It's a real contribution from artists. More you go, you're really increasing the dice, even in COVID times, it's uncertain. So I'm really thankful to Himanshu, you and Kartis, who have invited me on this virtual platform. So here I thought, because we are going through uncertain times, so I thought I would be talking on the perception of art and artists in uncertain times.
Right.
And I think every situation in life teaches us something to learn, who we are, how nature teaches us as individuals, as nation, as community. Art continues to inspire and give perspective to the human condition in time of disaster. I always say there are a lot of references of art directly, indirectly, which has been done in uncertain times. The visual artists have expressed their concern, experiences, engagements with such situations, be it war, epidemic, or floods, or any untoward incidents, could be in conflict times and other such things, because artists have been expressing their through own languages. I would like to share some of the images right from earlier to present, which includes mine too. So that would be, I would like to share the screen if it goes through. This will be the PowerPoint, and plus I would definitely talk about some of the works being done on these areas. As I said, the artists have been always engaged with such kind of issues, whether it is war, whether it's conflict, whether it's nature's fury. So in earlier times, this is the Mata Shitla. Shitla Mata was goddess of smallpox. So in those times also, artists were engaged with these images. You can see it in some of the temples or the worship places where these images has been.
Right.
So is the other image. You can see the graphic image here. So is the Ola Devi, goddess of cholera, being painted by folk artists for a long time. There are references as early as 2nd century of BC, even in Gandhara sculptures. You can see small eradicators to small boxes, a graphic work, maybe woodcut, the print in earlier times. This is Ola Mata, and this is this Gandhara sculpture in that time. So they were all concerned about these. Even in Bengal famine, if you see some of these images, most recent and familiar works are known from that time, Chitra Prasad Bhattacharya.
Right.
And artists known for his sketches and prints, and who documented a famine and book in the book Hungry Bengal. His artistic tenure as an illustration and sketch artist, Communist Party of India in early 1940s. Another artist was Jaisa Chitra Prasad. Another artist was Jaisa Chitra Prasad. Zainabuddin from Bangladesh, who also worked on these famine images like that. Zainabuddin. Also, when we see partition, similar in 1947, not a lot has been done, but there are some artists like Satish Gujral and Krishan Khanna who have painted the images during partition, which was a huge, you know, partition where millions have got affected. But no, I would not say generally it has been done so much, but yet there are some artists who have done it remarkably. We have another significant artist who, Zarina Hashmi, who has painted about the partition and loss of home. This is her one of the graphic works. It's similar in Bangladesh, in War of Independence 1971, we had Somnath Hoare, who has made some of this work, significant works. Many more artists, but Somnath Hoare I'm referring here because his wound series and other thing. Then we have K.G. Subramaniam, who has done the terracotta tile series on the Bangladesh War. So these are some of the significant artists who have worked on. It was Shahabuddin, who was from Bangladeshi artist, whom I met in Paris. He was who hosted the flag when it was got liberated. So he is a painter and been exiled since then in Paris. He was part of Mujibur Rahman's gang, and he was a good painter. Similar way, many people did also the illustrations and other things. So I will give another reference of Arpana Kaur, who have survived through the Sikh riots. She has worked on this issue. Similar way, Gulf War, where we wanted a lot of work with charcoal oil on oil series. Like World War II, we have Picasso, who has done Goranica and all. So likewise, in these times, many people like Jackson Pollock had worked on the similar thing. So the migration. Now this recent COVID migration, so it was our personal experience being here and watching and like looking at these migrants going back. So I have engaged in that time in a couple of days, some of these watercolor works on the paper to showing these migrants. My work is mostly personal, political. So this is one of the work of mine, which I did during last August, when Article 370 was, taken off from Kashmir. Since I was present here, so I could see the feel. It was similar with what I have faced in 90, but the only place were different. So they were suddenly that, you know, everything is shut down and people try to peep through. Right. And because it was a curfew, so that experience they got back with me, and it reminded me my past when we left Kashmir in 1990. So I used to paint like this, like making these migrants who are queuing for, for their registration and all. Right. These are my works of 1990, when I came and I don't know how to deal with life in bigger cities. So I start painting, that became very therapeutic kind, but yet a large series, which I then Mr. Al-Ghazi showed me in 1992 in his gallery. That's when my first show. And also talking about the human rights on a human angle of it. So that was my first beginning here. So I showed some of this work. It's later I've been engaged with then going with Kashmir. I went back after 15 years. So started engaging with the works, documenting the photographs, abandoned houses, and many more. Then I start doing many installations. Like this one of the installation, who says who I am, whether I am a migrant or I'm a terrorist or I'm a refugee or I'm a secessionist. So all that kind of installation, because every medium has a possibility and limitations. I use whenever, it depends what one wants to, express. So you use the medium. So I do paintings and sculptures, installations, videos, and all sort. Because the post-COVID, it may happen more because some of the artists are always engaged with communities. One of the project I did in Tihar jail, I got the artists and inmates together to work on. The idea was how, it was a very humble experience that I was in Tihar and I got 30 artists with 100 inmates who are mostly in the prison and convicted for 10, 12 years, 15 years.
Right.
They are there. So how to contribute, like once they come out, what do they do? Unless they don't have, you know, their sensibility is not grown enough because they are, because in society, they are not taken because they are from Tihar. So they don't get jobs, either they commit suicide or they become again, they start committing the crime because they find this is the only safest zone to be there with the people and inmates. So this is a big problem. So how do one contribute towards? So the artist has a role there. Mm-hmm. So here I'm working with a welder because they mostly do some work or the other. So they were making the chairs, chair furniture and other. And this guy, Shambhu, he is there for last 11 years. And it was very interesting to meet him. And he's a very good fine welder. Then I made him to do, I did draw this sketch and made him to do, and we did this work in the Tihar with them. So he was very amused and he felt happier. He said, I will sahab up next year out. Otherwise he was telling me, I want to run away from here. And I said, why do you run away? Because it's 1 year or more you stay there.
Right.
Your term will be over. It happens psychologically when you're closer to the, you know, finish, you feel like running. So there are many learnings from this Tihar jail. So it's one of the work I did after for the Tihar. So also it's very important to engage in, that's what COVID teaches us, to how to engage with, environment. This is in Mangalore, where one of our Arun Kumar, who runs this foundation and who is more concerned about ecology and water crisis, and also he collected all of us to do posters for that. Then we went there and again, continued with the school children. They have been going through the road march to make consciousness in that village and in that kind of area. So this is where art gets engaged. This was one of my posters there. We pledge to return and save the Western Ghats. These are other posters of other artists. There's a lot, many artists have really contributed. This is one of mine, homeless but not hopeless. So, then we also, here in Gurgaon, we have been engaged with these activists as an artist. So this was for saving the biodiversity park. There was a plan of the government to make a road through it. So we all got together and I made this and made people, it's like scarecrow, made people to stand wearing this. So that's, and there's Arun Kumar's, those poster also. So we got people engaged with the basic problem. This is how in society you are useful. It's not that we are living in, you know, jungle or in isolation, that we also eat the same bread and butter. So we also are concerned with the same concerns, same engagements. To see and feel, that's what I like about the Cartier's festival, that you are engaged with the people and the material world, which is there, these automobiles,
right.
Which is there, where does it go? Where does the scrap go or where does it come from? How does a gaadi gets evolved, finally functional, because it's a carrier, and how does it get dissolved and yet become something, piece of art on the crossroads? These are indirect teachings basically for the communities. That's where I feel happy about. I always feel happy when somebody takes their own route and engage with the community. Finally, you're also engaging with the community as me, because I've seen a lot of people getting in, getting out, learning, doing, presenting, and finally putting it somewhere where millions pass by. Because galleries are very closed spaces. It's only few people can reach, and physical reach is very less. And when you go into the open spaces, site-specific, so it does reach to many. See, this is our engagement at Biodiversity Park.
Mm-hmm.
I think, can art connect communities? Yes, it can. Yes. So I've been also engaging with the communities, especially in Kashmir and with Kashmiris, because they had left Kashmir 30 years back, never went back. So I collected all the artists who have left anywhere. So we got them back in Kashmir. But at least 60 artists got together, and the local artists there who have not visited 30 years, 20 years, 10 years. So we did this project in an abandoned place, which is a silk factory. It's a 100-year-old abandoned place in British times. There was silk was very much exported to the best from the Kashmir, but they are now abandoned. So see how emotionality there are. Two of my teachers, when I was studying, I studied there for 1 or 2 years.
Right, sir.
So when they got together, that is Bhushan Kaul and John Mahmud, who got together after 30 years and through this art exhibition. So they all got together, and it sends a good message. And now, earlier, it was sort of struggle to tell them, come back, there's nothing wrong.
Right.
It was struggle, but finally got convinced many of them that when they reached, they said, oh my God, we want to live here. You know, the kind of love they got from a counterpart who already are there, the Muslims and these pundits got together. See, art has a power to connect the communities. This is one of my installation there I did with this slick, which machine which is abundant. So some parts of it, these are wheels which weaves the silks. So it is a part of my work. Then similar way to Srinagar Biennale, I was invited to Kochi Biennale. I call it Srinagar Biennale. So I made this in one of the spaces I was given. So I made this Dargah sort of thing. I said, Dargah is the most revered where all communities to come and pray. And both the communities were coming to. So I got these performers from Kashmir, the young artists, and who performed. They did a search, like you have been always searched before you on the roads, that's their experience. So before coming into exhibition space, everyone was searched. It was their performance for 12 hours, morning, 9 to evening, so the couple. And there are some works of other artists. I got engaged in Kashmir with photographers, writers, video makers. So I saw how, and especially those who are born in conflict, or who are affected with conflict, how do they see? How do they see their life? How do they? How is your expression growing? So it was one photographer, and there was one other artist. So these kind of works around that Dargah. So you do a parikrama around Dargah and see these photographs of some photographers and other artists. This was Biennale project, of course. I showed somebody. This is someone's video, who has made video on a grave digger who has been only digging graves for deads. And his story was very different. So he was telling his stories. So this was put there. It was another artist, Mohtisham, Gargi's painting, who painted then Mujtaba's. And this was my installation. And you go inside. So there were these coffins made of paper mache. It's a paper mache work on it. So this is a shrine where you go in and see this, and there are bones inside this coffin. They're small coffins, like how many children die, they continue dying. And so, and the bones are also painted in a paper mache, because it connects you to the place directly.
Right.
Look at this. So these were my works. This is the how I exhibited, and there's a verse on the different verses I have printed on the coffin lay. Here it is a Lalde's verse. Some who have closed their eyes are wide awake, some looking out at the world are fast asleep. So many quotes from different people who have expressed death in a different way. So I make it very, very human, because the bones are bones. It could be of anyone. It could be soldier, it could be civilian, or it could be anybody. So that was my concern, and that's how I do. I painted bones, and this was one of the works, carrying bones in a paper mache work. It was part of Serendipity Festival, art festival. This was also Serendipity Art Festival. This is like giving tribute to 5 poets who have talked about conflict ever since, from 14th century, like Lalde to Aga Shah Deli. There are Iqbal to, you know, Mantu, who have, and there are what they have said, and that had been recorded, and that had been sung over the years, over the decades. Now I made new singers to sing what they have been, because these are the verses, and so one can hear them, how they have sung and how they have written. So that was my project at Serendipity Art Festival
too. Interesting.
This was one of my earlier house, abandoned house, which I made installation at India Art Fair. 2015. It was basically after floods hit Kashmir, and how so a lot of fear was created. So I did some of the works. This was one of the installation I did. I also make video, and which is running inside the house. That's how I did it. And also did the Shrapnel series, like how Gandhi, because Gandhi saw beam of light in Srinagar when he visited in 1940. He saw the hope. He saw the most peaceful place was Kashmir. So today I was saying, oh, Gandhi should be here to be as a welder to the shrapnel. So this was one of the series I did after my some experience in Kashmir itself. So I saw 100 boys got killed in the same day. So shrapnel, this automobile parts scattered all over. So these drawings, then I did lots of drawings on the handmade paper, pasted on board, and then I did kind of installations you can get in so that it stays for longer. I did like that installations, and there's a video running. I am showing some of the works of the each series, and that is the end of it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for sharing the insight and your journey from starting to, and the especially very interesting to have seen the artist who have taken this during the COVID. It is relating to the COVID, what you have connected us through a journey of artists, yeah. Different artists. That was really interesting. And it's an honor and a privilege to have you here and see your journey also as an artist, how you have connected the community as well as people, especially with the Thiar Jail project, what you did. It's something is giving back to the society, what an artist, how artists can connect and how artists can really give shape to the society. This is something inspirational.
It's everyone's responsibilities, artists are not different. Like you have to connect to whatever happens. Like it's a COVID time, you've got to connect. And because this is, nobody is in isolation. We are interdependent people.
Right, sir. Very right, sir. And as you know, sir, the numbers are increasing here in Jaipur. We have curfew. It is imposed at 8 o'clock in the night, and everything gets shut out at 6 o'clock. But then also my team and everyone somehow able to pull this out. And we are very happy to share with you that we have almost around 60 speakers from different fields to come and share their words in which it could not be possible without support of people like you. Today, we are extremely sorry because we have some technical issues. So we have to bring you on Zoom live with me only. And we will put it live.
This is our new experience talking to screen. Don't know what others are reacting or what would, you know, all the same, because it has a bigger reach. Always you find the possibilities.
Very true, sir.
So
very true.
It was a new learning. It was a big learning. We could do what we could not do otherwise.
Very true.
So take it positive. I am happy that you have done this festival, and I'm sure you have a lot of audience will connect with it. And
thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. And I will share the link soon with you. Thank you so much, sir, for coming to the Kartis Festival. It's a pleasure to have you here at the Kartis Festival 2020. Thank you, Veer Munshi ji.
Thank you.